And the word says, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. And not our own. There is a fight going on. Amen. And, you know, we've talked about multi-dimensions. There's three dimensions. Veils. You know, and there's dimensional veils. There's dimensional veils, personal veils, and creation veils that separate. I'm going to say that there's dimensional veils, personal veils, creation veils, and there's walls of protection and veils of deception. All create bondage and self-will. Has everybody got it? They all create what? Bondage and self-will. In other words, the enemy will put a veil of deception. In fact, he establishes veils of deception. That's what happened when Lucifer was removed. Veils came, separating, causing dimensional realms. One of the things the enemy likes to do is to cause you to create your own walls. They are false walls of protection to protect self. And people don't even know that they're doing it. We have a teaching called Personal Walls. I encourage you to go to it. It's on Eternal Library, Personal Walls. So in this arena where there are walls of protection, these veils of deception need to be burned through. You destroy a wall, in other words, where Jericho, when the Jericho built a wall of protection, what they did is they marched around it seven times and for so many days, and then they all shouted. And when they shouted, the walls came down. Because there's power, everyone say power, in your mouth. The word says that life and death, there's power in the tongue of life and death. And the purpose of this is so that we can penetrate areas, burn out areas, destroy areas. Nothing is won without a battle. Amen? In Matthew 26, in verse 36, you know, the Bible says that the enemy seeks whom he may devour. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Amen? Amen. In verse 26, is everybody there? I mean 36. Chapter 26, verse 36. Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane and said to the disciples, sit here while I go and pray over there. And he took with him Peter and two of the sons of Zebedee, and he began to be sorrowful and deeply distressed. And he said to them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. Stay here and watch with me. He went a little farther and fell on his face and did what? Prayed. He prayed. He spoke. Saying, oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. Then he came to his disciples and found them sleeping and said to them, what? Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is what? Weak. In other words, the spirit is willing to do the right thing, but the flesh is weak to the influence of darkness. Again, a second time he went away and prayed, saying, oh, my Father, if this cup cannot pass away from me unless I drink it, your will be done. And he came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. So he what? He did what? He left them. Went away again and prayed the third time, saying the same words. And he came to his disciples and said to them, are you still sleeping and resting? Behold, the hour is at hand. The Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. Before Jesus could surrender his life on the cross, he had to tear his personal veils. The word says that he was created in the image of man, even though he was God. That means he had a spirit, soul, and body. Each one has a veil. He had to tear his personal veil, so tear the veil of separation between man and God. He had to first tear his own. Is everybody with me? He said, the spirit is willing, the flesh is weak. In other words, because of the force of the enemy that prevents breakthrough. How many of y'all know the devil don't want you to break through? Jesus had to access the most holy place to release the promises of God. And so do you. And so do I. Why? Because the word says, unless you do his will, the promises are not released. Let me tell you, without the glory of God, this is one of the things the Holy Spirit said to me. He says, my people, do not touch my glory. They're not touching my glory. See, there's three chambers in a tabernacle. There's the outer court, the holy place. And then the most holy place. The most holy place is where the Ark of the Covenant is. That's where the glory of God is. He said, they lack in touching my glory. You know, Jesus gave us the prime example. Jesus had to deny himself, didn't he? He had to pick up the cross and fight to follow the will of God or fulfill the will of God. Many are actually weak in spirit and strong in flesh because of lack of touching the glory of God. Not feeding the spirit man enough for the next attack, the next deception, or the next decision. I'll say that again. They're not strong enough. They're not feeding themselves sufficient enough because of the lack of touching the glory of God. And they become weak in spirit, strong in flesh, and not strong enough for the next attack, deception, or decision. That's why fear loves to creep in and worry. You know, word says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High, which means under the shadow of the Almighty, the wings of the shadow of the Almighty. That's where the Ark of the Covenant is, because on the Ark of the Covenant is the mercy seat with the two wings of the cherubim touching one another. He said, no evil shall befall you when you're in there. Then why does evil befall people? Why does it have access? Because they don't touch the glory enough. Is everybody okay? So that means there's something that you and I have to do. We have to praise through. He says, seek me with all of your heart, all of your will, all of your strength. People make it routine ritual of praise instead of heart praise. Sometimes mind prayer, really not going through all the way. They can't sense themselves busting through every veil until they touch the glory. Because see, when you touch the glory, you change. You change. If you haven't changed, it's because you ain't touched the glory. Is everybody okay? 1 John chapter 2. Personal veils. What occurred was last Sunday, I think it was Sunday. We were worshiping and impressing through. And I saw three individuals that the Lord said they're weak in spirit. They compromised the worship. They compromised. By the end of that day, two of them were gone. And a couple days later, the other one left. I thought, wow, he said they were taken out by the spirit of Antichrist. And I said, why? He said, because they did not touch my glory. You cannot survive without my glory. There's a difference. There's the presence of God, then there's the glory of God. He said, my children compromise. They become lazy and complacent because they don't touch my glory enough. They lose their zeal and their fire. They lose their what? Zeal and their fire. And you know what they do? They hold to the gifts. But yet they've lost. See, you can pray in tongues, cast out devils and everything else and still not be lose and still lose your zeal and fire. He said, so they look at their gifts to think where they are, and that's incorrect. Just because you still pray in tongues doesn't mean you lost the zeal and fire. 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15. It says, do not what? Love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And this is something that we're, you know, it's not that we're not accustomed to. And the world is passing away in the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. Let me tell you, without touching the glory, you cannot do the will. People will be deceived because they got into God's presence but didn't touch the glory of God, and they believe everything that they hear is of God. Amen. And it is deception. Watch this. He said, the world is passing away in the lust of it, but he who does the will of God abides forever. Where did Jesus have to burn through? He had to get to the what? Most holy place. He had to burn through every veil of spirit, soul, and body. Get to the holy place so he could tear the veil for man to be reconciled. Verse 18, speak it with me. Little children, is the last hour, and as you have heard that the what? Antichrist is coming. Even now many antichrists have come, by which we know that it is the last hour. See, the prince of the power of air of the world is antichrist spirit. He'll do everything he can to prevent you from touching the glory of God. He fears the glory of God. In fact, he was removed from the glory of God. Has everybody got that? Verse 19, it says, they what? They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that they might be what? Made manifest that none of them were of us. But you have an anointing from the Holy One, and you what? You know all things. I've not written because you don't know the truth, but because you know it, and that no lie is of the truth. Who is a liar but he who denies Jesus is the Christ, anointed one in his anointing. He is what? Antichrist who denies the Father and the Son. Where is the Father? He's in the most holy place. Whoever denies the Son does not have the Father either. He who acknowledges the Son has the Father. Therefore, let that abide in you which you have heard from the beginning. If what you heard from the beginning abides in you, you also will abide in the Son and in the Father. This is the promise that he promised us. What? Eternal life. These things I have written to you concerning those who try to what? Deceive you. Deceive you. But the anointing which you have received from him abides in you, and you don't need anyone to teach you. Why? Because the Holy Spirit desires to be with the Father. And he wants you with the Father. But as the same anointing teaches you concerning all things and is true and is not a lie, and just as it has taught you, you will abide in him. Antichrist spirit influences people to compromise, to become complacent, or become lazy. And the result of it is because weak in spirit, strong in desire of self-will. Weak in the spirit, strong in a desire of self-will. Everything that doesn't... Listen, I'm going to give you an example. I was talking to a gentleman on the phone the other day. Somebody introduced me to him, and anyways. And I was talking with him on the phone, and I could tell by his language and certain things that he was saying. He was putting things out of order in the area where he was talking about his family was number one and so forth and whatever. And as I was listening to him, I was realizing this guy's out of order. And then he was asking me about what's what, and so I shared him what we do. He said, "You said filled with the Spirit." He said, "Do you believe in the full gospel?" I said, "Yeah." He goes, "Oh, you're one of them." I said, "Yes, I am one of them that believes in the baptism of the Holy Spirit and casting out devils and laying hands on the sick and touching the glory of God." He said, "Well, I'll talk to you later." And I got off the phone. I thought, man, this guy's never reached the third chamber of the tabernacle, the Most High. In fact, he's never even come out of outer court. Because, listen, and it's because the praise, he hasn't praised through. He hasn't praised through each one of his own personal veils of deception. And I thought, my gosh. And I could sense, and I didn't say he wasn't saved. Sure hope he makes it anyway. But without the presence of God, the power of God, the glory of God, listen, you got to touch the glory of God every once in a while. You got to touch the glory of God. We got to touch the glory of God at least once or twice a week. I got to touch the glory of God. Because I can begin to sense deception come in. I can sense, see, then your spirit, why? Because your spirit must be strong. Without touching the glory, your spirit's not getting strong. Oh, your soul's being renewed, your mind and everything else with the word, but without touching the glory, your spirit is not getting strong. And your spirit should be the strongest part of your being. Stronger than your soul and stronger than your flesh. Amen? Everything in this whole arena. See, then it becomes about self, family, and money. Has everybody got it? It becomes about self, family, and money. Those are signs of not touching the glory. Self, family, and money. Why? Because what happens, they start to lose and compromise the taste for kingdom living and kingdom business because of the lack of entering the most holy place. Again, the results is loss of zeal and fire, even though they hold on to the gifts and tongues. Amen? The lacking of touching the glory of God. I'll say that again. What happens? It's about self. It's about family. And it's about money. Those three things become priority. Oh, I love the Lord. I love this. Oh, really? Then why? Search your own fruit out. That's a lack of touching the glory of God. And I'm telling you, we got to touch the glory of God more. Is everybody okay? 1 Peter chapter 1. The enemy creeps in, says, "Oh, I've done enough. I worshiped enough. I don't need to press all the way through." See, burning through, you cannot burn through the veil, you must praise through it. Has everybody got it? You praise through, then you burn through. First Peter chapter 1, verse 13. All the glory. Is everybody there? Let's speak it together. Therefore what? Gird up the loins of your mind. Be sober and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As what? Obedient what? Children, not conforming yourselves to the former lusts as in your ignorance. But as he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all of your conduct, because it is written, be holy for I am holy. And if you call on the Father who without partiality judges according to each one's work, conduct yourselves throughout the time of your stay here in what? Fear, reverence, honor, and respect. Knowing that you were not redeemed with what? Corruptible things like silver or gold from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers. In other words, look at the traditions that are handed down. You need to be somebody. You need to make a lot of money. You need to take care of your family. You need to. Listen. When God is first, everything else is taken care of. I'm not talking about, well, God is first in my life. Then you got to show him he's first. You must touch the glory. Touching the glory makes God first. Without touching the glory doesn't make him first. Verse 19. But with what? The precious blood of Christ as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. He indeed was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifested in these last times for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. Are you ready? Since you have what? Purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit in sincere love of the brethren, love one another fervently with a pure heart. Having been born again, not of corruptible seed, but incorruptible, through the word of God, which lives and abides forever. Because all flesh is as grass, and all the glory of man is as the flower of the grass. The grass withers, and its flower falls away, but the word of the Lord endures forever. Now this is the word by which the gospel was preached to you. Purified the soul in obeying the truth. That means submitting, surrendering, desiring, seeking the Spirit, praising through, burning through the veil of the soul of emotion. The soul of what? Emotion. Because people make too many decisions in how they feel. That's the lack of touching God's glory. It's a veil that must be burned and kept burned. They make too many decisions in how they feel. I love my family. But if he's not first, I won't maintain my family because he does. I must touch the glory as much as I can so I don't make emotional decisions, so I don't allow the flesh of senses to make a decision for me. Does everybody understand this? The lack of touching the glory of God is causing too much problems in the kingdom of God. Because people are really not getting into the third chamber. They're still going to the first and second. Yes, it's wonderful to live in the second chamber, which is the presence and power of God. But the glory of God is what brings creation. Hebrew 4. Hebrew 4, verse 11. Again, you and I are made of a spirit, soul, and body. Is everybody there? Let us therefore be what? Diligent to enter the what? Rest. Where is the rest? The most holy place. Lest anyone fall according to the same example of disobedience. The word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even the division of the soul, the spirit, and the joints and marrows, and is the discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Let's go a little further. And there is no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are naked and open to the eyes of him to whom we must give account. Seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest. And where is he? Most holy place. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without what? Sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace. And where is that? Third chamber, most holy place. That we may obtain mercy and find grace, God's plan. To what? Help in time of need. See, many people don't get the answers because they haven't touched the glory. Then they walk in assumption. They're misled by how they feel. They are misled by circumstances. Touch the glory and answers come. Is everybody okay? Well, God's word is not only his word, it's his voice, it's his presence. It exposes the personal veils of the spirit, soul, and body. We must praise through to the most high place of rest. It takes fight. It takes endurance. It takes a willing heart. It takes a desire to touch God. Because when you touch him, he touches you. Listen, the lack of touching the glory of God will reflect in lack of divine nature, divine character. It will allow the old man to influence. Are you listening? Good, I hope you're hearing. It will allow the old man to influence. Why? From memories. Old man memories. Your past. The reason why people are allowing their past to influence them because they're not touching the glory enough. Influence. Oh, hallelujah. The lack of divine nature create a character, will, and desire resulting in a weak spirit. The lack of touching the glory will reflect in a lack of divine nature, character, will, and a desire resulting in a weak spirit. Allowing the old man to influence. The soul to influence by feeling and emotion. And the flesh to influence by senses. They will begin to drift from the zeal and fire and kingdom living. It can bring a course change by a selfish decision. Your course of life can change just like that. Just like that, one decision can change the course of your life. Amen? One decision. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Weak in praise, weak in victory. Everyone say, weak in praise, weak in victory. Because praise is a weapon, isn't it? 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Personal veils. They need to be burned through. First Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 22. Let's see. Let's start at verse 17. Rejoice when? Always. Pray without what? Ceasing. In everything give thanks. For this is the will of God and Jesus Christ for you. Do not what? Quench the spirit. Do not despise prophecies. Test all things. Hold fast what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. Why are you not going to do that without touching the glory? Now may the God of all peace himself sanctify you what? Completely. And may your whole what? Spirit, soul, and body be what? Preserved blameless at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Wow. Three parts, right? That your whole spirit, your whole soul, and your whole body become blameless. In other words, there should be a union there. God is trying to bring union of your spirit, soul, and body in Christ. Like-minded, like-willed. He who calls you is faithful, who also will do it. We must sanctify. You cannot do this without touching the glory of God. It's impossible. Everything will come out of order. Divine order is established with a divine nature. Has everybody got it? It starts by touching the glory of God. That's where you came from. We came from the glory of God. We need to touch the glory of God. See, you can praise and worship and never touch God's glory unless you're willing to press all the way through. Too many people give up. They're really not seeking the Lord with all their heart. They'll sing the words, okay, let's get the message and go home. Never having that desire to really grab hold of God. See, worship with all of your strength. Go after him. When you touch his glory, you've entered the most holy place. No evil shall befall you. Again, it's the lack of touching the glory of God, which is causing a lot of problems. That's why people drift. They think just because they have tongues or the gifts that everything's okay. And that's not true. Things come out of order. Why? Because then family comes first, money comes, everything else comes except for God's presence and glory. Actually, I'm going to go to Psalm 24 first. You know, one of the things that happens without touching the glory of God is, again, fear begins to come in. Lack of trust. We begin to rely on our abilities and talents. Lack of trust. Remember, the old man begins to come more forward. The soul becomes more emotional. And the flesh becomes more sensitive to senses. Instead of strong in the Lord and the power of his might through the Spirit becomes weak, everything falls out of order. Psalm 24 and verse 3. Who may ascend into the hill of the Lord? What does it say? Who may stand in his holy place? Who he has what? Clean hands and a pure heart. Who has not lifted up his soul to an idol? Hello. Nor sworn what? Deceitfully. In other words, he's saying these are requirements to enter the most holy place. He shall receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is Jacob, the generation of those who what? Seek him and who what? Seek his face. His face is in the third chamber. Not in a second. Who seek his face. Now let's go to Psalm 15. You must fight through. Psalm 15. And verse 1. Let's speak it together. Lord, who may abide in your tabernacle? Who may dwell in your holy place? He who walks uprightly and works righteousness, who speaks the truth where? In his heart. That means that there's an inward walk. He who does not backbite with his tongue, nor does evil to his what? Neighbor, nor does he take up a reproach against his friend, and whose eyes a vile person is despised. In other words, you don't approve of it. Amen? And you don't take no garbage from it. Because if you're weak in spirit, you'll be weak in that. You'll let anything tell you what to do and whatever. You got to be strong in the Lord, and you can't be strong in the Lord unless you touch the glory of God. You not become, listen, if you haven't touched the glory enough, then you become weak in spirit and you become a man pleaser instead of a God pleaser. You become fearful what may happen to you. But the word says, if God be for you, who can be against you? So then you're not really relying on what God's promises are because you haven't touched the glory of God, where his promises are released. And whose eyes a vile person is despised, but he honors those who what? Fear the Lord, reverence the Lord. He who swears to his own hurt and doesn't change. No compromise, no complacency, no wavering. Stay strong in the Lord and the power of his might. He who does not put out his money for usury, nor does he take a bribe against the innocent. He who does these things shall not be moved or not compromise. Amen? See, there's a religious political correctness going on these days. It's disgusting. People are just doing the forms and really not touching the glory of God. So in other words, they're doing their duty. That's a terrible place to be. I got to go fulfill my duty. Forget it. That's an abomination to the Lord. He says, come to me and seek me with all of your heart, all of your mind. Seek my face, not draw pictures of it. Seek it. It's only in the glory. Well, I'm seeking God's face. Watch. Oh, come out. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Oh, let's go to Psalm something. Remember, we want to burn through the veils of deception and the walls of protection. Amen? Veils of what? Deception and the walls of protection with praise through to the most holy place, touching the glory, which keeps zeal, fire, and kingdom business. The Lord, you know, look at the example of Jesus. What did he do? He left his family at the young age. They had to look for him for 3 days. They were so caught up with the travels and family and fellowship and all the other stuff that they lost the Son of God. Where is he? I don't know. I thought he was with you. Well, I thought he was with the family. Yeah, forget the family, man. Where was he? He was preaching. And then when I finally went and got him, pulled him out by the ear. Come with me. What are you doing? I'm about my Father's business. I'm about my Father's business. Okay, come on. We'll get about your Father's business, but it's not time yet. But you got to understand. What did he say when everybody was outside? And they came in and said, look at your family's here. Said, I'll show you my family, my mother, my father, my brother. Hey, these are the people that do the will of God. You can't do the will of God without touching the glory of God. Is everybody okay?
Amen.
Psalm 16, we did that, right? No, we didn't. We did. No, 16. 16. Verse 7. Weak in praise, weak in victory. Like it, he got to praise through to the worship and the touch the glory. Verse 7, is everybody there? I will what? Bless. How do you bless the Lord? Praise. You don't bless God by drawing pictures of him. Hallelujah. Oh, I love the Lord. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord who has given me what? Counsel. My heart also instructs me in the night seasons. I have set the Lord always before me. You can't do that without touching the glory. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be what? Moved. You got to throw me out of that third chamber. Therefore, my heart is glad. and my glory rejoices. My flesh also will rest in hope. Well, where's it going to rest? In the glory. See, all senses and all emotions die in the glory. It's now spirit to spirit. They all get turned off. Boop. It's like a switch. Hit the glory. Third chamber, everything's out. See, everything in the second chamber and the first chamber is artificial. Does everybody understand that? They had to light the candles. They had to sacrifice in the first chamber. It was all tradition rich, artificial, associated with creation. It wasn't until they got to the third chamber where the glory was. See, his light lit the whole place up. Nobody else. Nothing artificial. Has everybody got it? Nothing man-made. God made. Therefore, my heart is glad. My glory rejoices. My flesh will also rest in hope. Verse 10. You will not leave my soul in Sheol or hell, nor will you allow your Holy One to see corruption. You will show me the path of life, and in your presence is what? Fullness of joy, and at your right hand are what? Pleasures forevermore. In other words, promises released. Bless the Lord by tearing through the personal veils of deception and walls of protection with praise through to the Most High place and touching the glory. What does it do? It keeps zeal and fire and kingdom business. Keeps the Lord before you, gives you the path of life and joy, joy, joy. Amen. Blessings from God. Why? Because you're not moved. Why? You're not compromised. You won't be moved. You won't compromise. You won't be a man pleaser. You'll be a God pleaser. Amen? Amen. Psalm 18. Psalm 18. There's that song we sing, I will not be moved. Everyone's been moved lately, some way or another. Verse 20, let's speak it. The Lord what? Rewarded me according to my what? Righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands. He has recompensed me. For I have kept the ways of the Lord. I have not wickedly departed from my God. For all his judgments were before me. I did not put away his statutes from me. I was also blameless before him, and I kept myself from my iniquity. Therefore, the Lord has recompensed me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands in his sight. With the merciful, you will show mercy, yourself merciful. With the blameless man, you shall show yourself blameless. With the pure, you will show yourself pure. With the devious, you will show yourself shrewd. For you will save the humble people, but will bring down the what? Haughty looks. For you will light my lamp. The Lord my God will enlighten my darkness. For by you I can run against a troop. By my God I can what? Leap over the wall. As for God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is proven. He is a shield to all who trust in God. Him. All who what? Trust in him. For who is God except the Lord? And who is erotic except for our God? It is God who arms me with strength and makes my way what? Perfect. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer and sets me on a high places. He teaches my hands to what? Make war. So that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. Praise God. He rewards us. He rewards you when you touch the glory. Has everybody got that? Everybody gets rewarded with touching the glory, one way or another. You don't know how the reward comes, but it comes. Psalm 145. in verse 10. What's it say? All your works shall what? Praise you, O Lord, and your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power to make known the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all what? Generations. Think about this. In the old covenant, when they set up the tabernacle, the glory of God was always present. Always. It was by cloud or by fire. The glory of God was always present. But it was only the priest that could really enter the glory, the third chamber, and Moses. Moses got to be with the glory of God. Somebody understand that? But much is given, much is required. Amen? Moses spoke to God face to face. Think about that. And what did Moses do after he spoke to God face to face? He still said, I want to see your glory. He says, all right, hide over here, because if you see me the way that I am, you'll explode. You blow up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to allow you to see my back. And he covered him while he went before him. Because he would have blown up. He would have died. The glory of God would have ripped through. Listen, I've tasted the glory of God a couple times. And if it was full blown, I wouldn't be here. But what was sufficient ripped me apart. I was taken in a glory cloud, totally changed. One time the glory of God came upon me in the living room. Mom saw it, my wife saw it, and I looked like I was having an epileptic seizure. My body could not handle the glory of God. They moved the coffee table because I flew off the couch like a fish out of water. They were going, oh my God. They thought I was hurting. I was having a great time. Every bit of breath left me. I had no breath in me. At first, all left me. Every breath in my body was gone and then replaced with his glory. And I couldn't handle it. My body couldn't handle it. My mind wasn't even going to try and figure it out. I was just a flip of flopping and rolling. And then his face came in. His face came. And I saw his face. And he said, be not dismayed, I come to dwell with you. When I was on a, and my language was flying. Every kind of language was coming out of my mouth. Not perverse, okay? Every tongue. It was almost like I was interceding for every nation globally. Some first reaction was, what's the matter with him? Call 911. My wife said, hold on. That's the glory of God. See, we can't enter the glory of God with this flesh, but we can touch the glory of God. Amen? Yes, I want to go home. Glory. Let's go a little further. Verse 14, the Lord upholds all who what? Fall and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look expectantly to you and give them their food in due season. You open their hand. You satisfy desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, gracious in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desire of those who what? Fear him. He will also hear their cry and save them. The Lord preserves all who love him. But all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and all flesh, I don't care whether you want to hear it or not, too bad, shall bless his holy name forever and ever. Amen? Praise God. Psalm 145. Psalm 149. I think I'm getting drunk again. Oh, the glory of your presence. Psalm 149. Is everybody there? Praise the Lord, okay? Sing to the Lord a new song and in his praise in the assembly of the saints. Let all of true ministries and total freedom rejoice in their maker. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name with a dance. Oh, we do that. Boy, do we have Holy Ghost aerobics Friday night. Amen. We broke tradition Friday night. Woo! Let them sing praises to him with the timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people. He will beautify the humble with salvation. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Say that again. Let the saints be joyful in what?
Glory.
Let them sing aloud on their beds. Hallelujah. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand. To what? Execute vengeance on the nations and punish the peoples and their kings with chains. Bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. To execute on them the what? Written judgment. This honor have what? All his saints. Praise the Lord. So the reason, you know, we praise and worship and so forth and get refilled, refreshed so that we can get redressed. We want to stay dressed with God's glory. We must touch the glory of God. You got to touch the glory of God. Or we become complacent, compromised. That zeal begins to drift, the fire begins to drift. Listen, you can read the word 24/7. And still not touch the glory. Amen? We've got to come to a place where we want to touch the Word. Because He is the Word. He is the glory. In 1 Peter chapter 5. Personal veils. First Peter chapter 5 and verse 6. What does it say, please? Therefore what? Humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God that he may exalt you in due time, casting your care upon him for he cares for you. But let me tell you something. Without touching the glory of God, you exalt yourself before time. You begin to reward yourself. Has everybody got that? Humble yourself, casting your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Verse 8, what? Be sober, be vigilant. In other words, be awake and be what? Consistent. Be awake and be consistent, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may what?
Devour.
Resist him steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world. Everybody gets attacked. So don't blame people. People bring on their own stuff. Amen? The only reason why the enemy's penetrating is because we're allowing it. But may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you what? Suffered a while. Perfect, establish, and strengthen you, and what? Settle you. That means you're not going to move. And to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. And I'm going to close at Psalm 1. You know, after you've been at places that touch the glory, you're not satisfied going other places. unless you've drifted and become compromising and complacency. Amen? See, I was not brought up. After I got born again, I was in a place that's what we live for, touching the glory. Touching the glory. So I don't know anything else. I live to touch the glory of God. Because I know when I don't touch Him, I'm miserable. My wife will tell you that. I hate compromise and complacency. And I hate when I miss. I hate it. When I realize that there's something that I missed, man, I know. I didn't touch the glory long enough. I didn't press in hard enough. Psalm 1, verse 1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, praise God, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scorned soul. So that's blessed is a man who avoids all these things. You can't avoid those things without touching the glory. Amen? Amen? But his delight is in the law or the truth of the Lord. And in his law or truth, he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in judgment or reward, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall what? Perish. Perish. Again, weak in praise, weak in victory. Without touching the glory. Praise allows you to burn through every veil. We want to seek His face. We don't want to fall short, become traditional, hold on to cultures that become bondage. God is always doing something new. He's always doing something new. He wants to touch us, change us. But you got to get in the glory. You got to touch the glory of God. Amen? So we can burn through these things. Father, we thank you for your word. We are honored and blessed. Let the seed that's been imparted bring a thirst and hunger to want to touch your glory, to burn through the personal veils, the veils of deception, and the walls of self-protection. Help us burn through with seeking you with all of our hearts and all of our minds and all of our wills. As you said, seek my face. If my people would humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways and seek my face, I would heal them. So, Lord, keep us on fire. Let us not compromise what you've done. Let us maintain an attitude of gratitude, remembering where you brought us from, that we may know where we're going. So, Lord, let that seed be protected, and let your glory rest upon each and every one here today. In Jesus' name.